field of augmented reality is entering an exciting new phase of development as we hit the perfect storm of mass proliferation of supported devices, delivering the camera quality, processing power, network connectivity, and battery life to support rich AR experiences. Coupled with the mass market adoption and usage of AR through globally ubiquitous apps like Snap with face filters, Facebook and Instagram, and of course Pokemon Go's visual discovery capabilities. There's also the groundswell of support and continued investment from the likes of Apple and Google, with low-level SDKs in ARKit and AR Core, providing world tracking to more developers. And finally, there's the opening up of mobile web AR, removing the requirement of a native app for AR experiences. So the floodgates are well and truly open for a more digitally connected AR world. Now, our own work over the last 8 years has proven time and again AR's capabilities in connecting the physical world of things to devices as a new digital discovery channel for spatial storytelling to drive active engagement and sales. Augmented reality is quite simply turning a brand's owned real estate through products, packaging, prints, and places into its most valuable, controllable, and measurable always-on media channel with reach. We now have the power to have a direct dialogue with end users on the device that matters most to them in their lives, their smartphone, at the point where they are interacting with your brand and product. And this shift is profound, and it's happening now. More and more global brands are taking this very seriously at the highest levels of their organization. Brands like Nestle and 7-Eleven, Hasbro, Tilly's, Pez, Rovio, Walmart, and many more have implemented AR as a facilitating technology and part of their omni-channel approach to marketing and sales. Now, with this explosion of interest in AR comes a lot of confusion. It's increasingly a difficult space to navigate for any brand owner, with all the jargon, buzzwords, SDKs, and platforms that keep cropping up. It's also the case that AR can meet the needs of multiple stakeholders and use cases within any organization, from enterprise to consumer, learning, training, and development, to marketing promotion and product packaging. So you need a solution that can be both future-proofed and perform a number of disparate functions well for different use cases, whilst integrating seamlessly into existing back-end systems. At Zappar, our goal has always been to democratize augmented reality, and through our proprietary algorithms, platform, and SDKs, create robust, scalable, efficient, and effective solutions that meet all the needs of our partners. So what I'd like to take you through now is the different and important layers of the AR ecosystem that we've built. Each layer is important to understand and consider to meet the needs of your business. The first layer is scanning, detection, and tracking. Now, you need an AR solution that has the ability to work across the majority of devices, both on iOS and Android, to quickly recognize the image it is trying to augment in the camera view and follow its relative position in every camera frame. We've developed a number of algorithms to deal with all the different types of scanning, detection, and tracking you might need, from face tracking, 1D and 2D barcode scanning, image tracking, to extended world tracking. We specifically patented and worked on a number of different code scanning and detection schemes with our own ZapCode, which has led to custom codes for the likes of Hasbro on Transformers, My Little Pony, Furby, and Littlest Pet Shop. For Shazam, with their Shazam code scheme, and 7-Eleven in the US, amongst many others. We've also created new alphanumeric code schemes with manufacturing partners like Crown to be able to recognize codes under the ring pull of cans, for instance. And we've worked with existing code schemes like data matrix codes and QR codes to start an AR experience. We also see the requirement for image tracking, say on legacy packaging where codes can't be incorporated, or face tracking for social share features and world tracking for the arbitrary placement of content in the camera view. We're also working on geolocation functionality with a number of partners to offer other content delivery opportunities based on specific venues and store locations. Finally, as we have a very active R&D department, we continue to work on new scanning, detection, and tracking solutions. One example is in mixed reality with our ZapBox product. Think Microsoft HoloLens, but for $30, not $3,000. And this system features a new point code methodology that allows for large-scale room-tracked experiences from multiple code tracking on existing mobile phone hardware. The detection of a point code in an image is found very accurately when only 20 pixels across in the camera image. So we offer the full range of scanning and detection and tracking algorithms to meet all possible use cases. The second layer of the ecosystem is, of course, the all-important content creation layer. It's one thing to be able to scan, detect, and track a physical object or place, but that's not that useful to an end user unless they can get a great experience from it. So we've built our own award-winning AR authoring and publishing platform from the ground up, specifically to make the most immersive short-form experiences made for the mobile occasion. And this platform is called ZapWorks. ZapWorks is a downloadable desktop client that allows any team to have the greatest breadth and depth of tools at their disposal to make the widest range of bite-sized content, from 360 video and gyro experiences to face filters with photo and video sharing, 3D model and animation support with scripting capabilities and timelining tools to make mini games, their support for high score tables, coupon redemption, deep links and more. The import pipeline for ZapWorks is optimized to work with existing assets and models made with industry standard software, using Photoshop and Illustrator, Maya and 3D Studio Max. So it's a perfect complement to the existing solutions used by most designers and developers. Quite simply, ZapWorks offers the best content creation environment to help manage the disparate communication needs across all your channels and use cases. Better still, you can build once and deploy cross-platform on iOS and Android. ZapWorks is used by our internal creative team to build experiences, but it can just as easily be used by your own internal teams and indeed your agencies to deliver and manage the content, as is often the case. So that's scanning, detection, tracking, and content creation covered. The third layer is serving, hosting, and analytics. A really important part of our ecosystem and unique offering is the ability to serve content over the air and avoid the need for any additional app submissions and updates for new experiences. That also means that the same code on a product or pack, for instance, can serve different content at different times if required, depending on where the product is in its lifecycle, and indeed where the user is when scanning. This level of contextual relevance and ongoing conversation with your audience through updatable AR experiences opens up totally new opportunities from previously passive print and static media. Note also that all our content is statically served, allowing the ability to serve thousands of scans a second if required, and ensuring it can be reliable for deployment at global scale. Behind it all, ZapWorks offers a data dashboard, which allows you to get rich analytics in near real time on total scans, unique users, dwell time, specific events completed in an experience, the operating system used, location and time of day for a scan. This makes every interaction measurable and accountable without falling foul of GDPR. And this data can also be downloaded as a CSV file and imported into your own analytics system if required. So this data not only drives greater accountability, but also allows you to hone your message for your audience and learn over time. The fourth layer is making the function into a light SDK that's easy to integrate into an existing app or new standalone app. Our component is only around 3 to 4 megabytes in size, and it only takes a few lines of code to incorporate into your existing project. The Zappar libraries do all the heavy lifting. There's no need for the host app to manage the camera, the 3D rendering, content delivery, or analytics. The Zappar SDK has been integrated into scores of apps, so it's a proven path across operating systems. The benefit here is in being able to add a new camera feature with AR capabilities to your own app to drive installs, active usage, and connect to all your physical real estate as part of your omnichannel strategy. Finally, the fifth layer is the ability to determine the best distribution method and channel partners for your content. What we're seeing is a general shift from AR use for simple one-off surprise and delight moments to include experiences that instruct, inform, and reward more as an everyday utility. More brands are looking to stop thinking about AR as a tactic and start thinking about how it fits into their overall business strategy as a facilitating technology. One of those important strategic questions at the start of the process is which app to use as the connection partner for your AR experience, if not your own. The reality is that not every brand or product can command the home screen real estate, user interest, or cost of their own standalone scanning app. The alternative is to look for apps that have an established audience, an existing role in their lives with mature and proven AR capabilities to partner with. And the main contenders here for businesses at this time are Snap and Facebook on a global scale, or local sector specific apps like 7-Eleven, 7Rewards app, or the Tilly's app in the US in the retail sector for CPG partners. There's also our free to download Zappar app, readily available too, which has been used by many brands for their activation when required. Now, working within the walled gardens of Snap and Facebook, of course, comes at a media cost and is more suited to a one-off marketing campaign activation rather than always-on function. It also suffers from the fact that you're not then accessing real-time first-party data analytics to connect directly with your audience. So what you gain in reach and self-expression with these platforms for social shares you're perhaps losing in ongoing capabilities, diversity of content delivery, and direct dialogue with your end users over time in the right context. But there is a new world order with the increasing viability of mobile web AR as an alternative and direct distribution method beyond native apps. Now, mobile web AR isn't as mature or consistently performant across devices and browsers as AR delivered through a native app yet, but we're already beginning to see a means by which brands can access capabilities in a route to market with AR without the requirement of an app or a social network connection partner. And this is hugely significant for CPG brands and anyone who doesn't have an app but wants to connect with their end users across different channels and collect first-party data on those interactions, in a GDPR-compliant way, of course. Right now, the latest Apple devices allow for QR code scanning natively through the camera, as does Samsung's Bixby service, being rolled out across all new S-Line devices. Coupled with mobile web AR, there will be instant access to AR capabilities for hundreds of millions of devices across the world. And that really is game-changing. So there you have it, the five layers of the AR ecosystem: scanning, detection and tracking, content authoring and publishing, serving, hosting and data analytics, simple and light SDK integration, and finally third-party connection and mobile web distribution channels using Zappar technology. Now you might be asking, well, where does AR Kit and AR Core fit into all this? Well, actually it sits below, but is incorporated into our scanning, detection and tracking layer and hardwired into our content authoring platform ZapWorks. It exists in the background and just works, so designers and developers can use ZapWorks to create compelling content without having to worry about how to plumb this in across platforms. Better still, we're also working on our own visual inertial odometry, the technical term for extended or world tracking, which will increase the amount of supported devices with this capability beyond those supported by ARKit and ARCore. We've been building the Zappar platform for over 8 years now, and have continued to lead the way in research and development, pioneering new approaches to ensure that our partners have the best platform and tools available to capture value in AR. The important question before deciding what platform and distribution method you're going to use is how they can deliver against each layer of this vertical ecosystem. What's evident is that AR itself is not a strategy. It's a facilitating technology. The technology itself is not interesting to users. It just has to work. It's how you deploy it in the brave new world of spatial storytelling to open up new moments of discovery for your audience, to build engagement, relevance, and drive growth for your business. That's where the AR magic really happens. And that's where you need to make sure you have all the right capabilities at your disposal to capture the most value in augmented reality in the short, medium, and long term. You now have the power to turn all your passive print into your most powerful, always-on media channel, communicating directly with your end user to drive value. That is a huge step change and offers a media environment money can't buy. And if it could, would be worth billions of dollars to the business. The question now is, what will your brand say and do in the brave new world of spatial storytelling?